Everyone. Hello.
So I'm a total idiot. I said I was going to do the first episode of Black Ops 3 Nightmares last Thursday, but I totally forgot I had a prom to go to. So I didn't record and I didn't post, as you can probably tell from my channel. But that's okay, because it'll be this week and we'll have fun and it'll be lit, so stick around. But yeah, this episode, we're gonna do a lot of Enderman hunting because this is getting ridiculous. We're episode 20 now, and I still haven't killed the first boss. And it's starting to make me mad because, honestly, you know what I mean? It's ridiculous. So anyway, we need some blaze powder. Oh my god, people are texting me, stop. Alright, where's the blaze powder? Do I not have any? Hey, buddy. How's it going? Oh, right there, duh. Alright, so I just need one because translate two, right? Yeah, alright. There's that, and then there's that. Now we have two more Eye of Enders. We're not gonna get all of them in this video. But I would love to go to the end soon. Like, not even joking. I don't even care that I don't have a full set of diamond armor yet. I don't even care. So we're gonna wait for nightfall. I guess we'll work on the melon house until nightfall, but this, I want to get at least, I don't know what our goal is, but we're not going to sleep the night in this video, probably. I really need to get some Enderman, and it's just ridiculous. It's honestly too much. I want to go to the end. I want to start an Ender Pearl farm. That's what I really want to do. I just want to be able to look where I'm going and be like, okay, well, this is boring, so Ender Pearl, and then I just want to be there, you know what I mean? Oh my god. Plus, teleportation is my favorite super. Are you kidding me? I just want to get up on that pumpkin, thank you. Oh yeah, I forgot. Sorry, Ryan. God, it's like you don't play for a week and all of a sudden you forget what you did a week earlier. Wow. Alright, melon time. Yeah, I know they are, but it's gotta be done, you know what I mean? It's gotta be done, and it's turning to nightfall, so we'll go, we gotta start, like, right away. I want to go into the end so bad. I realize I could just do it off camera, but I don't like to play off camera. I like to record almost, you know, I like to record as much of the gameplay as I can. And I know there are parts of that that can get really boring for viewers. But, I want to put up the whole gaming experience. Especially for people who, like, aren't as lucky as me. And, like, people who don't have the option to play Minecraft and they just want to watch people play it. Then they can see what it's really like to have to do everything that you need to do everything, to like go to the end and stuff. So it's I mean, like, I'm not trying to like rub it in anyone's face. Oh my god, I just realized my volume is really high on my TV. Oh no, I'm dying. There we go. So yeah, it's pretty ridiculous. Where are the Endermen? Endermen. It's time to kill some Endermen. Seriously? Just make sure I'm on hard mode. Okay, I am. So what's with the dealio, man? What's going on here? Where are the Endermen? Oh my god, They're so geared, it's ridiculous. Why does a zombie need golden armor for? Not that it matters, because golden armor is like weak as fuck, but still. Armored zombies. And skeletons, look at this guy. Look at him, he's got gold armor. There, die. Don't like you. Piece of schnit. Alright, where? I'll take this XP, I guess. Roleplay. What do you mean by a roleplay, my friend? Why did I put cobblestone in this tree again? There's gotta be a reason I put cobblestone. People don't just put cobblestone in trees, right? There has to be a reason. I've definitely been here before, right? Can we just establish that? Yeah, I took the bushels from there. The bushels. Where are the endermen? Ender Island players? Ender Wigan? I hope in years to come somebody watches this video and understands those references. Ender! We want an Enderman! Ooh, he gave me redstone. Come on, what the deuce, bro? Seriously, there's no Enderman. We just wasted a whole night looking for freaking Enderman. We couldn't even get one to spawn in. Oh my god, this is utterly ridiculous. Oh shit. No, I didn't want to fall in here. Alright, where are the freaking Enderman now? I know one's gonna be over here, right? Are you joking me? You gotta be joking. This is oppo lit. This is the opposite of lit. Because it's nighttime, it's dark out. Enderman! Oh my crackle. Are you joking? Screw this. This is a pretty big desert, man. I don't know where they are. Come on now. Come on now. Y'all come back now, yeah? Alright. You think that could be really big? Do I have wood on me? Alright, let me make a, don't know why I have so many crafting tables on me, but that's okay. We'll make a boat. Boat, please. We'll make two just in case. Just in case one of them fails. Oh, give me you. Give me you again. Alright, ready? We'll go over there and see if that is any better, this desert over here. Because if we can, all we need to do is get them to spawn, you know? God, finding Enderman would be a lot easier if I was in the end. But you know, you can't get there for like a million years. Because, you know, once you start a YouTube channel to televise what you would normally do, the game becomes 10 times more difficult. And it takes 10 times more longer for you to do things that you would normally do when playing the same game. It takes... I'm so angry. What's going on here, man? Where are the Endermen at? Literally, if I could just get one to spawn. Like, it doesn't even need to drop anything. I just want to find one Enderman. Alright, we'll try this desert. We'll keep searching through the day, because I know it's going to turn to day in a minute. We'll keep searching through the day for a big desert. That way, when it comes to nighttime, this episode might not be too productive if we're just, if all we're going to be doing is running around and, like, yeah, it's not going to be too productive, but that's okay. This is a big desert. I feel like if they're going to spawn anywhere, it'd definitely be here. Especially since it's like nice and flat, but we'll check up on this cliff as well. See what we got. See what we got. What do we got? What do we got? Alright, you know what? We'll do this. How about, nope, host options. Here we go. Alright, watch, ready? Ah, no, it just went. To daytime. That kind of sucks. Tell you about this desert, man. All right, ready. Stop, stop. Don't go away. Don't go away. Don't go away. Don't go away. There you go. Yes. Yes. Oh my. Oh no. I think I accidentally threw this bucket on the ground. All right, let me do that before I accidentally use it. Finally got an Enderman and he dropped us something nice. You know, contrary to popular belief, some Endermen are nice people. You gonna shoot me? I was kinda hoping you'd kill me so I could go home. But looks like I'm gonna have to drown myself. Jump in the water. Because they're getting whacked with the sword. Pretty sure you would scream if you were getting whacked with a sword. Now wouldn't you, Liz? Sorry, that was really aggressive. I'm just messing with you. But seriously, though, you'd scream. Alright. Now that we're home. Now that we're men. Alright, now that we're home, I'm gonna go add these. Actually, we'll get some more. Well, okay. I'm not that much of a wimp. Are you kidding me? You freaked out at me when I stepped on your dress. Alright, here we go. Oh, schnit. That's my biggest pet peeve in Minecraft. When you go to place a block and you mess it up, it makes me so upset. And, like, I know it's, like, 100% my fault and not at all the game's fault, but still. Makes me really mad. Oh my god. Why? Why do I become so popular when I'm off stream? God, alright, let's get these pumpkins. And then. And then here we go. Alright, let's go place these pumpkins. Alright, ready? Huh! Fuck! Messed it up. Alright, ready? Huh! Oh, yeah. That was a loud, huh, but that's okay. I think I placed those right, right? Wait. No, it got messed up. Oh, wait, no, it didn't. Did it? Because that's supposed to be like that, right? And the two in between are supposed to be like. Are you sh- No, that's not how it's supposed to go. I fucked up somewhere. Alright, let me fix this. Are you fucking serious right now? Alright, there we go. So this has to be backwards, like so. Alright, we'll break all those. So, okay, so that faces in, which means this is out. Means this is in, out, in. How is it now? Good, good. How about out here? Yeah, all right, we did it. Okay, I got so scared for a minute. No, I haven't named the dog yet. Carrot, please. Oh, no. I just wasted a carrot. All right, let me kill this cow. You think maybe if we go down in the mine... and you think maybe if we find, like, a cave, there'll be some... Look at this guy. He's like, I want to hump another pig. There aren't any more pigs, sorry. What's that? Oh, lava. Lava? What did one volcano say to the other? I lava you. Well, that's actually kind of sucky. I didn't even realize that. Alright, is there... No. We're just gonna jump in the lava. No, actually, no. We're gonna try and get out. Alright, there we go. Are you kidding me? Go. I just figured. Did you hear that? I heard an Enderman. Did anybody else hear that Enderman? Where is it? Where's the Enderman? No. Oh. There he is. Well, that's not an Enderman. Where is he? Hello? You're not an Enderman. Get out of here. Where's the Enderman? He's gonna despawn. There he is. There he is. There he is. I gotta get up there. I gotta get up there. Come on. Shh. Where is he? I don't know where he is. Where'd he go? Nope. Where'd he go? He's in the water. Oh my god. Oh my god. Did he drop anything? Come on. Tell me he didn't drop anything, you son of a bitch. I almost died for that little shit. Okay. You motherfucker. Die. You piece of shit. You literal... Alright, let's get out of here. So done. That was hectic. Oh my god, really upset. God, this is turning out to be kind of nice, though. I think I'm gonna put... I'm gonna tear down. Do I have flint and steel somewhere so I can burn down that fucking tree? Let me burn down that fucking tree. Do I not have flint and steel? Oh, it's right there. Here. Flint and steel, please. Oh, God forbid this burn down the whole entire forest. That would kind of suck. We'll chop down a little bit of this just so we have a little bit of extra wood anyway. I'm just too lazy to get all the big pieces up there. I hate when trees grow like this. I like how they randomize a lot of stuff in Minecraft. Like, you can only get this drop 10% of the time, or, you know what I mean? I think this is where I might make the library. I think I might make the library down here, because this is the most bland part of the, the most bland area around my house, so. Maybe I'll fill in this cave, because it doesn't go anywhere important. Get that iron first, though, because that's important. Iron, please. Oh. Oh, whoa, look where that led to us. Look where that led us. That's kind of funny. Alright, let me collect a couple of these saplings anyway. So I can replant if need be. But yeah, for now, we're not gonna start building the... library yet, but this is, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna fill in this hole a little bit, at least a little bit, and put it there. Let me cut down this tree as well, because now, since I got rid of all these trees that were here, a lot more space to do whatever I want. See all this extra room once the leaves break anyway. Pretty lit. Is this gonna burn? Burn, please. Burn, tree, burn. Burn, burn, burn. Burn, tree, burn. Burn, 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 burn. What if I just lit my house on fire? Oh my god, there's so much stuff here. It's ridiculous. Okay, there we go. So we have five. Oh, look at that. When did we get all of that? Where are my blaze rods? Blaze rods! There you go. Oh wait, can I make more? Yeah, I could, oops. There you go, now I have four. Which means I have 10 of them now. Who needs sugar? We don't need that. Alright, it's nighttime. Let's go find some freaking Enderman. Enderman? Oh my god, I'm sorry. I keep yawning. Well, actually, I think that was my first time yawning. Actually, it might not have been. Actually, it doesn't matter at all. So, I'm going to shut up now. But, yeah. Yeah, man. Enderman, we just need one. We just need one Enderman. That's... Or 4 or 5 would be nice as well. Not at the same time. But it'd still be pretty cool. Alright, let's, oh! Hello there, my friend. We've been expecting you. I just need to get you alone. I don't want to... Oh my god, there's 3 spiders and 2 creepers. Actually, you know what? It would be easier if I just let the creepers blow up. There you go. Alright, let's get this one. What if by the time I was done, I should have let the creeper blow the enderman out there? Aw, he didn't drop anything. Yes, I'm gonna live stream almost every part of the series. No, aw. Yeah, I'm gonna live stream pretty much the whole series. There's not gonna be much done off screen. Cause like I said at the beginning of the video, I don't like to play unless I'm recording. I don't like, especially for a series like this, I don't want to... I don't, like, you know what I mean? Like, I want to post the whole experience online for anybody to watch. Because then it gives people a chance to see what it would really be like. Like, if they can't play Minecraft, then they can, like, see... Have I been to this village before? This is the same one I was at earlier, I'm pretty sure, but that's okay. It's totally fine, I just want to make sure. I've literally been to this village like 4 or 5 times. And each time, I think it's a new village for like half a second. There's another guy, by the way. Ow. Oh man, this freaking skeleton's gonna like boot me back. Boot me back. Boot me back. Boot me back. Freaking piece of shit. Fucking asshole. Alright, oh man. Alright, let's go get him. Let's get him, get him, get him, get him, get him! Get him! I don't want to hit him in the water, because then he'll teleport and get mad at me. So for some reason, the Endermen in this video feel like being dicks. Go! Okay. Yeah, especially something important like that. I'm not gonna live stream. I'm not gonna go to the end if I'm not live streaming. Cause that's such a big milestone for the series anyway. You know what I mean? Which, by the way, I know I've been throwing out arrows. I really shouldn't be. Because I'm gonna need, if I don't get infinity, unless, do I have an infinity bow back at the house? I might have an infinity bow. Was that a creeper? Oh, it was. I just walked right through a creeper. Kind of feel violated. But yeah, as I was saying, we should definitely be collecting bones. I mean, not bones, arrows. Because the end fight. If you don't know what I mean by that, then you will towards the end of the series. Stick around! So far, this has been a pretty cool series. I mean, sometimes I run out of stuff to do, but that's just my creativity running amok. What's that? Oh. Let's get out of this clearing at least so we can see if there's any Enderman. Hello? You know you want to... I wish you didn't have to kill Enderman for Enderpearl. I wish there was like a semi-expensive crafting recipe. Think about it. Like a spider eye mixed with like... I don't know, blaze powder... and sugar or something. Some really stupid crafting recipe like that would be fitting. for an ender pearl. Eventually they'll probably put a recipe in for it, but it'll be like really expensive because ender pearls are like, for me anyway, it's kind of like an end game thing. Literally, and not just because it has the word end in it. But like, it's like, you know, when you're playing a game, usually you get the good stuff either towards the end of the game or after you have been playing for a while. Good night, have a good day. Have a good day, my good sir. Enderman, please. Oh, I wanted to get a collab on that guy. Oh my god, I'm yawning, I'm so tired. Please, give me a ding, Enderman. Why do Endermen feel the need to be so bad? Hi, it's the Wolfenstein. Hello, Wolfenstein. Why you do this? Alright, we might as well get some coal. It's daytime, there's not gonna be any more Endermen. We'll just get this coal. Oh my god, we're out of space. What do I not need? I definitely don't need this 20 sand. No, wait, you know what? I don't need this boat. Don't need this gunpowder. I do not need this bow. Don't need the bow. Oh, this is cool. Oh. Sorry, I had an itch. Oh. Gotta keep yawning. Pumpkins. Whoa, those are some big ass trees. Holy schnit. Let's go cut some down. After we get these pumpkins. Pumpkin, please! Give me it. Give it. I don't think I collected that one. Pumpkin. 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 Look how big these trees are. 10 o'clock. At the time of this. Oh! Oh my god, dude! Isn't there like, hang on a minute, let me turn around. I love mossy cobblestone. Love, love, love. Oh my god, give it to me. It's beautiful. You can craft it now, which is amazing because it's a really good block to build with. And I love how they added these naturally in the game. They're supposed to represent boulders, but they're only in I don't know what type of biome this is. But, oh my god, I love seeing these around. The first time I saw them was on PC about a year ago, maybe. And I was like, what is this? Like, I didn't remember building it, so I was like, what is this? And fortunately, I was playing at Ryan's house. And he was like, oh yeah, it's new stuff they added to the game. I was so excited because look at it. It's like, it represents boulders, man. And then you can just See this? Look at that. Look at that. You can craft it by getting vines, and I've been meaning to do something with moss stone ever since it came out on the console edition of Minecraft. I don't know. I just, moss stone is one of my favorite blocks in the whole game of Minecraft, so we'll see what we can do with it. We can do some pretty cool stuff with it, so. Have you ever made a diamond block? Yeah, I have. Not in this world. And I don't really have a reason to at the moment. But, you know, good stuff, I guess. Like, I used to do a couple creative builds. Nothing too spectacular. I'm not the best at building, period. But, you can do some pretty stuff with it. With diamond blocks in creative mode. Yeah, look at this stuff. It's so pretty. God, what are we gonna do with all of it? Probably start making our own when we get back to the house, but I don't need that 2 cobblestone on me. I really don't need this netherrack, so I don't know why I still have it. But moss stone, dude, is... Oh, look at this. No, I just picked it back up. Pretty seeing stuff like this out in the wild. I was wondering when they were gonna put stuff like that in the game. Boulders. Or not boulders, but you know, like rocks like you would normally see out in the wild. Just cause, I don't know, simple things like that make the game better for me anyway. Hang on, if you break a block of podzol, you pick up, oh, you just pick up dirt. Dun 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 dun. It's gonna be night time so we can fight some Endermen. No. Look here. Thank you. I don't know, sorry, I just got so quiet for like a minute. I don't know why I was so quiet, I was just thinking. Thinking about love. Have people talking about people. They keep on thinking. I don't know the words. Holy Coolio. I like coal. Coal is, well, coal, man. That's so cool. Coal. So cool, man. So, dude. Alright. I half thought that tree was an Enderman for a second. Anyways, my life feels 10 times better now that I... Ooh. You know what? You know what I'm really tempted to do? Kill me. Yeah. I'm home. Oh my god. I always forget how much is in there. Put mossy. I only got 3. I didn't even get Three full stacks? I thought I had like a little bit more than that. I don't know why. Alright, right here. Extra meat. Mutton. Alright, we'll go add the puckins. Oops. Just put that away. Puckins. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, that's a lot of watermelon that grew whilst I was gone. It likes me. Oh my god. Gimme! Give you to me. Just because the pumpkins are a lot less easy. Annoying, a lot less annoying to place. I'm gonna do pumpkin. Fucking spoke too soon. Fucking fast piecing piece of shit. Fast speaking piece of shit. Alright, there we go. We'll do. Just give me that block of dirt for now. Alright, what's next? So we got. Out. In. Out, in, out, oh shit, in. Good night, Alex. Thanks for stopping by. Me? Angry? No. Alright, let's get this. Oops, Snoop. Snoop. Schnit. There you go. Wait, why don't I just do this? Because I don't want you in my inventory because you're really annoying. Alright, we'll do that. Alright, should we... We'll collect some of this wheat. Then we'll breed the cow. Cow. That... Tree still hasn't fallen. Olympus has fallen. Right, I'll take the XP for that, please. I spent a lot of time. That's cool. Are you serious? There's still chicken in there. I didn't even realize it.
Oh my god.
I thought that wolf was gonna go in there and attack all my. Seriously? Wait, do I not have fire spreading on? Oh, I don't have fire spread on. Oops. There we go. Now it should spread. Alright, it's night time. Let's kill them. Die, please. Oh, by the way. Puckin. Do you like puckin? I like puckin. Give it me. Here we go. Perfect.
Oh my gosh, I'm tired.
Wait. Alright, so this is in. Out. In. Out. In. Out. In. Out. In. How's that look? Yeah, that looks good right now. It's gonna look different from this view, but that's okay. There's nothing we can do about that. Alright, after this night... probably going to end the video here. Live stream. Oh my god, is this two witches? Oh my god, it is. Crap. Oh my god, I'm poisoned for like 30. They poisoned you for so long. I'm gonna be poisoned for like 30 seconds. Oh, jeez. Spoke too soon. Thankfully. Usually it's a bad thing when you speak too soon. Nope. creeper. Don't bother me. Creeper, go away. I hate how dark it is in these dark oak roof. I mean, not what are they called? Yeah, dark oak roof biome or something like that. They're very difficult biomes. It gets so dark in them that mobs can spawn during the day. Oh, he helped me that time. You know, I almost had an OCD attack because that creeper blew up. I almost went back and filled in the holes that it left in my heart. No, I'm just playing. Alright, where are the ender? Ender, please. I need the ender stoof. No! Are you freaking serious right now? That's gonna bother the hell out of me. I'm gonna come across that in like 10 videos from now and be like, what the fuck? It's magic. Is there something in Minecraft I don't know about? Is that a thing? If I go to the top of this, is there gonna be an Enderman waiting? Please. Please. Okay, I kinda wanna blow you up. Dang it, I wanted to blow him up without getting hurt. Wow, this is pretty. This mountain. This is a pretty mountain. Pretty mountain. Pretty bird. Oh, are you serious? Oh. Would be cool if I... Ow. Could have an Enderman. Pet Enderman that I could just kill over and over again. So I could get my freaking Ender Pearls from him. Okay, there's one controversy that I want to bring up. Just one. J.K. Rowling, the author of Harry Potter, wrote another Harry Potter book series about Harry Potter's fucking children. The series was fine before that. There was lore behind it. It was good, all the characters were young, but, she just wants to make extra money at this point. I don't get it. Why can't you just leave it? Leave it alone. Like, Rick Riordan, he wrote one series, and that was enough for me. He got rich off that one series, and that one series was so good, but then he made another series and crossed those series over, and then he made another series with the same characters from the first series, and now he just made a third one. Like, all these writers, they're just writing. I don't understand what's going on. Like, I was happy, like, you know what I mean? Like, okay, Star Wars. Let's say Star Wars. Shit, I just fell in a hole. Star Wars. Anakin was the chosen one to stop light and dark. Okay, so at the end of Return of the Jedi, he did exactly what he was prophesied to do. He stopped the Sith. He stopped the Sith. Yeah, and then The Force Awakens. He brought balance to the Force. For 30 years there was balance in the Force. For 30 years. Like no. That doesn't happen. Like, I love The Force Awakens, don't get me wrong, and I cannot wait for the next new Star Wars movies to come out and stuff like that, but oh my god. Sometimes it's just ridiculous what people are, like, you know, it makes no sense. There was balance in the Force for 20, he was the chosen one. He was going to bring balance to the Force for, you know what I mean? And then, like, there was a whole 7-book series that I think took J.K. Rowling, like, 10 years to write for Harry Potter. And then she ended it like, oh yeah, everybody lived happily ever after. And I respect that. But now she's writing, like, I could understand if it was about another witch or wizard. But there is an entire, J.K. Rowling created an entire world. Like, of Harry Potter. She created the whole entire Wizarding World universe and stuff like that. And for some reason, she had to pick the same exact character to write about. The same exact, like, not the same character, but the same family to write about. Cassandra Clare doing the same thing. I agree. Although, I am a fan of the new series that she wrote, I'm reading Lady Midnight right now. I really like it. I feel like she planned to write that series though. Whereas with J.K. Rowling, it's been, how long has it been? 6 years since the last Harry Potter movie, and she's starting to write another book series about his children. But whereas with Cassandra Clare in that new series, she actually referenced it in the last book of the last book of the Mortal Instruments series. She like referenced it, and it kind of made sense to me. Like, I could have seen it coming, kind of, that she was gonna write it. But like, after Return of the Jedi, they didn't think they were gonna make more Star Wars movies. After Revenge of the Sith, there wasn't supposed to be more Star Wars movies. You know what I mean? So, like, they didn't plan to do all this stuff, and now all of a sudden, like, I'm gonna read all of the books that J.K. Rowling posts about Harry Potter, but and the same thing with Rick Riordan. I'm probably gonna read all the books. Doesn't mean I'm gonna enjoy them. Nothing will ever beat for me. Reading Percy Jackson in sixth grade was like, oh my god, this is amazing. But you know, 8 years later, it almost seems like he's just doing it for the money, or B, the book series is like fighting for just popularity now. Because back in the day, Percy Jackson was one of the biggest, and in some ways it still is one of the biggest books, like the most read books by young kids, because kids don't usually like to read, but they like fantasy stuff like that and violence. And that's exactly what that was. And, I just feel like it's the same thing over and over again. Like, he ended the series, the first series, Percy Jackson, The Olympians, That he ended it perfectly. And then and then he just used the same characters 5 years or 2 years later. Like, I watched an interview with him, and in the interview, Rick Riordan was saying how he didn't plan to make a second series. He just came up with the idea for a second series and decided to make it a reality. But he was like, oh yeah, I didn't plan for this to happen, but after close analyzing my stories and stuff, I realized I created just enough information to create another story 5 years after the world was saved. The world is gonna be blown up again. No, like, no. You know what I mean? Do it with whole new characters. Make it a whole different conflict. Like with the dark, with Cassandra's, Claire's shadow hunters and stuff like that. The first two series, like the first six books, which were basically two different series, kind of. Like the original trilogy and the sequel trilogy. Oh, I lost my train of thought. Dang it, I was gonna say something good. I don't remember what it was. Darn, I'm really upset now. Things are just like I'm excited for it. The new Harry Potter book is called, it's not Harry Potter, it's about his children. It's called The Cursed Child. Or something like that. I mean, I'm kind of excited for it. But at the same time, there comes a point where it's just like, no more, please, no more. Like, Harry Potter ended beautifully. There is no possible way she could have ended it any better than she could have. And now it's 19 years later, and there's a new conflict already. And I just think there's no, like, I'm not trying to rash on Rick Riordan or Cassandra Clare or anything. I love their writing. I love their work. I just feel like the series is that they respectively wrote, I just don't think that they need to keep going. You know what I mean? Like, I totally respect them. Like, I want to become a book writer myself, but there comes a point where it needs to end. I'm not, like, upset about, like, the new series and stuff. And, like, it's pretty cool, to be honest with you, because you get to see more into the world and stuff like that, and more stuff gets revealed to you, and maybe questions that you've had for years will be answered in the new couple series that these writers are putting out. But at the same time, the best feeling for me when I'm reading a book is that sense of mystery. Not knowing stuff, like the answer to stuff. I feel like that's what, like, curiosity, you know what I mean? Is what it keeps people going. And like, when you're reading a book, and let's say it's like a mystery book, and they're trying to find out who the killer is or whatever, nothing is more disappointing when you're sitting there thinking, 5 days before you finish reading the book, you're sitting there thinking, oh my god, the murderer could be anyone. I want to find out who it is. So I'm gonna keep reading. But then you finish the book and then you're all disappointed because it's oh, it was a character that was right in front of my eyes, or, you know what I mean? Stuff like that. Which is kind of difficult. But, I mean, I am excited to be able to delve back into the world of Harry Potter. And I'm excited for the upcoming movies that they have for Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. And hopefully, eventually, it would be cool to see more Harry Potter movies, like about the Cursed Child and the rest of that series, if there's going to be more than that book. You know, it would be cool to see them in movies. I always feel like it's fun to watch books become movies. Even though the movies usually suck in comparison to the books, but it's still cool to see what you've been reading about and, like, how you picture things versus how the author pictures things or how they decided to film it. It's really cool. If you're reading Harry Potter and she's describing the room that they're in, and you picture it in your mind, but then you see it on the big screen, it's just totally different from what you think. Or nothing's more satisfying when you're visualizing a room or a character from a book, and then you see it on TV and it's almost exactly what you thought it would be like. Like when I read the book series, I'm number four, I pictured the character to look exactly like Alex Pettifier, and that's exactly who they got to be him in the movie. I don't understand how some movies like that get the casting so perfect. Like, there is not a single person on this earth I would have rather had been John Smith in that book series / movie. Is this the same one I always come to? It is. Oh my god, I've just been running in circles this entire episode, but I don't know. Sorry, I've been ranting. But this, I don't know. I like giving my opinion about controversial subjects like that. But, yeah, I don't know. And, like, I understand if people need to, like, I don't know, maybe, probably not, but I don't want to start false rumors, but if J.K. Rowling was running out of money, I could understand why she would write another book series or start another, you know, write another book or a book series or whatever. I could understand that, but it's just kind of like, the first one was, it became one character's problem to, like, every wizard in the whole entire wizarding community's problem. But I feel like a really cool book series to have read about would be, like, one student whose mother or father was killed by, you know, a low-class Death Eater or someone that we haven't heard of or been referenced yet. I'm totally gonna swim to this other island over here. I feel like that would be fun to read about because, like, if it only affects a few people instead of it being apocalyptic, I feel like that would be really cool. There's a lot of book series now are about characters saving the entire world, but there aren't a lot of book series about people doing things for their own personal gain, or, just, like, low-class things, you know what I mean? And, I don't know, like, I don't want to go on and just keep repeating the same exact things I've been saying. Because, like I said, I am excited for these couple new series that these two authors are beginning. But I just don't want other people to... I don't know how to say this. I don't want other people to, I'm trying to think of how to say it. Oh my god, 25 seconds. I just don't want people to, get the wrong idea, I guess, you know? Wait, do you die in hard mode? No, you don't die of poison. Liz, what's your input on these matters? Oh no! Ooh, that was close. Is there anything you'd like to say, Liz? About anything I just said? Or whoever's watching anyway. I'm assuming it's Liz, but it might not be. Hurry up. Get across this lake so I can fight the skeleton so he can't shoot me. Alright, there we go. And there's an Enderman, finally. Kill the Enderman. Kill the... Oh my god, how embarrassing would it be if I died right now? How embarrassing would it be? Oh. I'm excited for the new book, but I just hope it isn't a parallel to Harry Potter story. What, J.K. Rowling's new book? No, it's about his kids. Like went on that huge rant. I got really excited. I do that a lot. You'll find. Oh yeah, no, that'll hopefully never happen. That'd be the most stupid thing ever, because she did a whole book series on how Harry Potter had to destroy him, and he had to do all these things, destroy the seven Horcruxes, blah blah blah. But I'm really hoping it'll affect like a small group of kids instead of like he basically had to save the world from Voldemort. And like there can't always be a series like that, like where the world's gonna end and then 10 years later the world's gonna end again and the superheroes have to do another few things to save the world, or you know. It's just, I'd rather hear a story about something that affects a small group of people. Like, maybe there's not even related to Voldemort in any way. Maybe there's a character, not necessarily a dark wizard, but like someone who isn't a good wizard. Maybe they steal a necklace or something that belonged to this family that's been in their family for thousands of years, hundreds, couple years, and they want it back. And, you know, that would be, I mean, that's kind of boring when I put it that way, but I'd rather have something like that than something totally apocalyptic again, because there's just so much apocalyptic stuff out there. It's kind of ridiculous. It was cool at first, and I was really into it. I loved reading, writing, and playing video games where the world's gonna end if the heroes don't do this, retrieve this item to save the world, or, you know, but there comes a certain point where it's just like, can we do something else now? Like the gods, like in Percy Jackson, he saved the world. But then I think it was only like a year or maybe even a couple months later. Oh no, the gods went quiet. They gotta save the world again. And I mean, Rick Riordan's starting this new series about how after the events in the what's it called? The Blood of Olympus series? Is that what it's called? No, that's the last book. The Lost Hero series? What is it called? I forget what it's called. Heroes of Olympus series. After the events in that, the god Apollo gets blamed for it. And Zeus punishes him by taking away his god powers, I guess. And I guess the story is told in the perspective of the god Apollo. And it's about how he's trying to get his powers back, as I understood it. And, like, how he's gonna get retribution or whatever. Or he's gonna try and make his father proud so he'll get his powers back. Which, that's pretty unique, I'm not gonna lie. Told in the perspective of a god. But at the same time, like, the illusion that gods live forever and that they've seen so much stuff that you couldn't even think of. They know almost everything. It kind of gets ruined because I feel like we're going to be... Because in this book series, we're going to actually see what it's like in the mind of the god. And that was one of the coolest parts to me was... you know, like, Percy and his friends are demigods. But what would it be like if... What goes through the gods' heads, and now, sorry, got the shivers. Now we're going to find out, and I just don't think we needed anything like that. I feel like it would have been just better off to leave it how it was, because that series ended so good. You know, so, I don't know, we'll see what happens, but, I mean, all in all, I'm excited for them, but at the same time, I just feel like it's not needed at this point in time. Like, pretty much, figuratively, Percy Jackson ruled the world at one time. Like, the book series was, like, amazing. It was, like, the most read young adult series ever. But now you can just see it's struggling so hard to gain more popularity. And there's more books. And I don't want to see that because... Back in the day, it was so prominent and it was amazing, and I remember it for what it was, and I want to remember it like that, and I don't want to remember it as a series that is struggling to get more viewers. That's not the right word, but struggling to get more readers and kids into it. And that's exactly what nobody wants to see from a book series. Especially something so amazing like Harry Potter or Percy Jackson, you know? They're, like, the two... In my opinion, they're the two biggest book series, and it's just... It's a shame to see them struggling like this. Nah, that's my personal opinion. Not that you guys might care, but I just figured I'd share it. Because it was really bursting my bubbles. I don't have friends to tell that sort of stuff to. Like, I have friends, but nobody cares about that sort of stuff. So I just figured I'd talk to myself. You guys can just listen. Sorry about that. Anyways, I think I'm going to end the video here because we're not having any progress. We got 4 ender pearls. We might be set. Hang on, let me drown myself. We'll go back to the house. Stuff like that. And I'll see how many pearls we got. Liz, you have anything else to say about that conversation? Here we go. All right, downstairs, please. Oh my god, I have too much stuff. Blaze rod, blaze powder, right here. Right, anything else? I agree, Harry Potter is really cool. I have a bunch of the wands because I'm a nerd, but is there anything you want to, like, say to contribute to the chaos that I just ranted for, like, half an hour? I think we had to sort this stuff, honestly. It's making me mad. Yeah, you too, Liz. Alright, guys. That's gonna do it for this episode. Thanks for watching. This was a good episode. I had fun. So, yeah. Enjoy everything. I will see you tomorrow with Skyblock. So, yeah. Bye-bye. Okay, bye-bye. For real, now. Bye.